Ecco.
Andiamocene. Guarcene.
Yes, scrive.
Yes, Samarna. Okay.
Yes, Samarna. Yeah, Amarnath.
Just I will share my screen so you can also. Let me know you are able to see my screen.
Not yes. I'm actually joining via laptop, Amarnath. Yeah, we can actually continue, but. If you can accept me in laptop, that will be helpful, I guess.
No, okay. Accepting not been can do.
Okay, I'll just disconnect this.
I think you are able to access, right?
Can you hear me now? Oh, yes.
I can hear you. Now you are able to hear me?
Yes, Amarnath.
Okay. So you are able to see also, right, in laptop?
Yes.
Good. It's fine. Okay. So basically, we are going to learn the Angular, okay? So at latest version for Angular, like 8 or plus versions, we are going to see right now, okay? So before that, just I'm going to give the introduction about the Angular.
Okay.
So meanwhile, what I will do, right? I will try to create one file for you for your reference and what are the topics we are going to cover. So in D drive, the batch 16. So Angular is a framework, okay? So something to understand, just AngularJS and Angular are two different things. AngularJS is an old version which we come with an Angular 1x versions. Means 1x means 1.4, 1.2 or 1.8 versions, okay? And currently they have moved completely from AngularJS to Angular, okay? This is a framework, okay? And when we are working in Angular, this is a latest version which is coming from the 2.0, okay? From 2.0, yes. They will call it Angular only, okay? Once we are developing any single page application, that is for the single page applications for mobile or desktop, we are going to use Angular only. That is a 2, 4, we have the different versions, 5, 6, 8, 9, 10, okay? These are the latest versions which we have seen in Angular in the past years, okay? So for building any client applications, we are going to use Angular, okay? That is with the help of an HTML, CSS, JavaScript or TypeScript, okay? So when we are calling the TypeScript, means again when we are running the compilation time, the TypeScript will be compiled and it will be converted into JavaScript only, normal JavaScript, okay? Just we want to know the what is an Angular 8, okay? In Angular 8, they have added the latest features which will help us to dynamic web applications like lazy loading, okay? At the time, we want to import multiple files or multiple functionalities in our component with the help of the dynamic web application loading, we can use that one, okay? That is the feature they have added in the Angular 8, okay?
Okay.
And apart from that, they've added the next feature, isn't it? TypeScript 3.4. Okay. That we are saying that TypeScript is going to support in Angular, right? So in Angular also, previously they have given support for the old versions, but they have upgraded TypeScript into 3.4. Okay. So in Angular 8 and latest versions, we can use the TypeScript 3.4. Okay. TypeScript 3.4 we can use. Okay, so what is the meaning of dynamic web pages, web applications? Okay, we are using, right? Most of the times we are listening this word. Okay, what is the meaning of dynamic? So previously also we have the JavaScript. Okay, with the JavaScript, in HTML, CSS, JavaScript also we can develop the websites or web application. Websites we can develop. Okay, why we are using the Angular is to develop the web applications. We are going to use Angular, right? Like in a JavaScript frameworks I leverage, we are using like in a Angular, React, Vue, anything Ember, like in a Ember, Backbone. This all the things we are using by developing a web application, dynamic web application. Okay, what exactly the dynamic web application is? It will update the site and it will not impact any other applications or other pages while reloading the application. Like suppose we are seeing any time to time the page need to be updated. Like if you are going to see the news page, right? News page like BBC channels or otherwise something like which are the live news updates. Okay, when you are seeing those things, the sites are going to update dynamically, right? The values we can say. Otherwise, if you go and see in the share market applications, okay, there the stock prices, every second the prices are going to update dynamically. Okay, those values also we need to, without reloading the page, we want to update the values in the front end. At that time, these all the applications will help us. Okay, means framework means Angular, it will help us. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. And another feature is like, I will write down here. So one is we are saying that into time updations. Ma'am, you are following me, right?
Yeah.
These are just example for you giving. We have the more things, but just I know some of the things I'm giving. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. The second one we can say that location based. Okay.
Yeah.
Suppose like when you are accessing the Uber. Okay. So Uber application, when you open, try to book the cab from your location to the destination. Okay. Most of the scenarios, you will not check on the pick. Sorry, we will not select the pickup location. Right. By default, it will select. Right. So
yes,
those
yes.
Applications also, the web application, dynamic web application will be help us. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Otherwise, like in a weather apps, suppose if you are seeing the your local temperature. Okay. So same thing, I have typed the message. You type the same message like in a local weather. So when I am in another location, I also type the same location. Okay, sorry, same text like a local location, local weather. Okay, I got the different temperature and different scenarios. So you got the different scenarios, but we are accessing the same application. Okay, how it is coming, right? Depend upon the location based, it giving the output to us. Okay. So for that also, we need to know the location of the particular, like in a client or we can say the mobile or app. Okay. Then only we can get the exact data.
Yeah.
With the details. Okay. And the third thing we can say that when we are a large application, like when we are using the Twitter, Facebook, the social media is there, right? There, previously when compared to 6 to 8 years back, we have the Facebook is loading, it will take some time, okay? But right now, it's loading fast. Why? Because we are using the lazy loading, okay? What is the screen size you are viewing, right? Only the content only we are going to load in the web page. And so once it is done, when you scroll to up, at the time only below the content is going to load, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, and this one is also user to user interaction will be there. Suppose if you like any, somebody posted some message or some photograph, you clicked on the like button. Okay, once you click on the like button, we need to update to all the users you have liked the particular like in a photo, a photograph or image. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Those things also we can do it dynamically by the help of a web applications. Okay. These all the things we are getting difficult to implement with the normal JavaScript, HTML, and CSS. Okay.
Yeah.
User to user interactions. So we can see user to user. Application or apps. Same thing. If you are working this in the mobile or desktop. Okay. So when we are seeing application in a web page, by the help of a URL typing in a browser, we will call them as applications. Okay. Mobile apps means once you install in your phone, like Android applications or iPhone applications, we can say. Okay. Those we'll call them as apps. Okay.
Yeah.
Like Gmail, Facebook. These are some of the examples we can say for the Angular thing. So just my question is, why we need Angular? Why? Because we know already thing HTML, CSS also we can achieve, right? So
yeah.
We are saying that with only help of Angular only, we cannot do that. Without Angular also, we can do that. But it gives us more flexible to maintain the application. Okay. Why? Because here in Angular, we can make the component based application and everything should be in a modules. Okay. It is for testing also. When you are developing application with the vanilla JavaScript, to test the application, it is taking the time consuming. Okay. Otherwise, if you want to do the unit testing, it is get difficult when compared to the when we are developing the application with the help of a framework Angular. Okay. That is the reason we are choosing the Angular. Okay. So it's giving more. You can say that less work to the developers to develop the application, and also for testing also it will help us to the developers. If you find any issues, we can easily solve it. Okay. When the application is also grows, to maintain also the Angular application is very good.
Okay.
It is also like in a, it will help us the front end, like in a front end guys, our development team also, it is a more useful with the help of an Angular framework when you are developing applications. Okay. And we can say the benefits. What are the benefits we are going to use? Okay. So first we can say that the benefit is application will be as a clean structure will be there. Like everything, like in a components, modules. In that one also, we have the different files, like in a CSS, TypeScript, and the logic will be the different files. Everything, that file will be the the folder structure, and everything will be in a clean structure will be there. The process we need to follow. Why? Because we are following the, we are developing the with the help of a Angular, right? So,
yes.
Application, clean structure. And also, when we are developing any application, we need to think about the reusability of the code. Okay, why? Because no need to write single function or single method double times. Okay, if the line is a 2 lines code or 20 lines or 100 lines of the code. Okay, so because of that, in normal JavaScript, we are going to use functions, but here we will use the components. Okay. So okay. If the function is in the same function, like suppose I will to give you an example, like an addition of a two numbers. Okay. So addition of a two numbers, we are taking that A equal to some value, B equal to some value, and C equal to, we are holding the result of an A plus B. Okay. And once we want to print that one, we will write the console.log C value, right? So C is holding the A plus B value. Okay. Same functionality we require multiple times in our applications. Okay. Don't need to repeat the 3 lines of the code multiple times. Because of that, we will make a functions in a JavaScript. but here we'll use the components. Okay, this is a one of the advantage why we are using the frameworks. Like we can say the code reusable. Okay. And another thing, just I have told you, like testing. Okay, in normal JavaScript operation, testing isn't a difficult task. Okay, right now we can do it easily. Okay, ma'am. In this one, we have any questions? Okay. Right now, we are in a starting position. Most of the things will be the theory will be there. Once we install our application, then we will go to the practical, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay, and one sentence we can say that Angular makes developer work easily. Okay, easier developer life easier we can say. Okay.
Okay.
Next, we are going to see the Angular versions. Okay. So, when we come into the Angular, we got into the Angular is an old version with an Angular JS. Okay. That is not in our scope. Okay. It will come on a 1x versions. Okay. 1x version, it is also open source when compared to Angular, also open source. Okay. But yeah. Here they have used the scope and they have morely focused on the front end only. It will work like same like in a jQuery. If you have an idea, same like we can add the CDN link and we can do it. Okay. And okay. It is also developed and maintained by the Google only. Okay. This Angular thing is going to developing and maintaining by the Google. Like React is maintaining and developed by the Facebook. Okay.
Yeah.
And it is in a first version of the Angular. Okay. Next, then going to the Angular 2. Okay, they have removed the JS, okay, from the name itself, okay, and they have completely rewritten.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, completely rewrite Angular JS, okay. What are the things they are using in Angular JS? They have completely rewritten, means from the scratch onwards, they have developed Angular 2. And here they have added a lot of the features, which we can say that it is a component based. Okay. How we are using the Java application in the same way they have tried to introduce in Angular 2. Okay. And it is almost all released in 2016.
Okay.
Here one defect is there that when you are developed application with the help of Angular JS, directly we cannot convert or we cannot upgrade to Angular JS. Okay. So okay. With the help of an Angular JS, we have developed any application, we cannot convert to the Angular 2 easily. Okay. That is a drawback for the Angular 2. When we are trying to develop Angular JS, we cannot convert because we cannot upgrade to Angular 2. Okay. We need to write completely. We need to start the development from the scratch onwards. Okay. Then okay. The Angular 2 is not Angular 3 is not there.
Mm-hmm.
So Angular 3 did not get any much updates. So they did not release it. Okay.
Okay.
So directly they have released Angular 4. Okay. So when compared to the in Angular 4, what are the features are there in Angular 2? Same features will be available in Angular 4. And also we can update from Angular 2 to Angular 4. Okay.
Okay.
From Angular 2 to we can do upgrade from Angular 2 to we can upgrade to Angular 4. Okay, ma'am. And it is also released in somewhat in 2016 only, at the end of the 2016. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. And here they have a rewrite also done. Some of the things they have features they have added and some of the features they have removed in Angular 4. but here also that morely focusing on the Java thing only. Okay, means how we are developing the application with the help of the Java. Same thing we can do with the help of an Angular 4. Okay, and it is also what can say developed and maintained by the Google.
Okay.
And next one of the features they have added in the routes. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Routes main purpose is like in a when we are working in a normal HTML file, we will use the anchor link to navigate from one page to other page. But mm-hmm. when you are working in a single page applications, means single page application means we'll call them an SPA.
Mm-hmm.
SPA. The single page applications is only in one page only we are developing the throughout our application. When the user clicks on any links or any buttons, we will change the one component to the other component. Okay. Otherwise, depend upon the user authentication and roles, we are showing the components. Okay. Those all the things will be do with the help of the routes. Okay. Those packages they have introduced in a Angular 4.
Okay.
Next, they have released the Angular 5. So only Angular 3 is not there. We can say that Angular. And what can say for developing the progressive web apps, Angular 5, they have added the package for it. Okay. They are mainly focused on the web apps. Okay. Sorry, progress. Progressive web apps we can develop with the help of Angular 5. Okay. And what are the features we have in Angular 4? We can use it. And also we can upgrade from Angular 4 to Angular 5. And they have released it in around 2017. Okay.
Okay.
2017, around after 1 year, it will come under November. No. And after that, they have released in Angular 6. Okay. In Angular 6, they have released around 2008, but they are morely focused on the front end things like ng add and some of the elements they have added. And also for UI and front end, they have added the material designs. Okay, so Angular material we can use.
What is this Angular material means?
Oh, Angular materials, when we are developing any framework, right, we cannot write from the CSS from the scratch onwards. Okay. Angular material, they have the all the things, like it will same kind of in a bootstrap kind of a thing. With the with the help of an Angular material, the basic structure will come. Like if you want to load any, sorry, if you want to create any button, basic styles will come. Like in a blue color button, like in primary means it will come under blue color button. If it is in a danger means it will come under red color button. Those things we come and we can use by default with the help of an Angular material.
Okay.
So they have given the support for that. And apart from that, they have added the animation kind of a thing and some of the performance improvements also they have done in Angular 6. Okay.
Okay.
So next we are going to see the Angular 7. Okay. It is really, it is also released in around 2018 after not 1 year, you can say. Okay. It is also mostly focused on the Angular material and the performance only. Okay.
Okay.
And they have added the next is, we can upgrade from Angular 6 to Angular 7. And also we can upgrade from Angular 5 to 7 also. Okay. Means older version also we can use here. Okay. With the help of the older version also we can upgrade from here. Okay. And also they have added the virtual scrolling and more accessibility. Accessibility will come under like who are having the blind or dumb guys, they can also our application is user friendly for them.
Okay.
They've added the RGX, not here. In Angular 6.6 only they've added the RGX features. Okay, RGX means when you are to use the any validations or anything else which is introduced in Angular, JavaScript latest version, V6 version. Okay. So we can, with the help of that, we can do the some validations and some of the code structure we can use with the help of a RxJS. Okay, sorry, JS will come under comes in it. Okay, next we can go to the Angular 8, what we are going to see. Okay. And Angular 8 is released around May 2019. Okay, ma'am. It is mainly focusing on the loading, ma'am. Okay. Loading and dynamic imports. Just I told you that dynamic imports means. Dynamic imports means when we are loading the page, right? Only the particular content will be loaded for you. Okay. So suppose if you scroll down, then only the content will be loading. Okay. So in the same way, they have added the dynamic imports. So with the help of what are the features you required, first of all, it will be loaded and it will show the at least structure to you. Okay. When you are loading the application, it will take some time. Okay. The user is unable to wait sometimes, like in a 4 seconds, 5 seconds or 10 sec, depend upon the speed. It will show the at least output of the output to the users. Okay. And apart from this, they've added the TypeScript 3.4 into this AngularJS. Sorry, in Angular 8. Okay. TypeScript 3.4. So, okay. So these are the different versions which we have seen in the Angular stream, means Angular versions. We have the different things. So depend upon our requirement and depend upon the our usability, we are going to use. Okay. So when you are developing an application in AngularJS, we cannot convert them into Angular. Okay. Angular X means 2 or 4 or anything else. Okay. So when you are developing application with the help of the Angular version, means Angular 2 or 4 thing, we can upgrade to Angular 8. Okay.
Okay.
Is it fine, ma'am? You have any questions here still?
Yes.
Now?
No, I'm good.
So next we are going to see the Angular architecture. So in the starting, we have the user front end. Okay. So front end means it will come under the user. In the, if you open your application, Google Chrome or Firefox, anything else, what the data we are seeing, that will call as a front end. Okay. Okay. So it will come under the user interface. Okay. So when the user want to interact with our application, what exactly it will do and what are the things will be loaded in the front end. Okay, so it will directly interact with the server, we can say, our back end.
Yeah.
So in the backend, we have the some of the things will be there, the same like in a front end.
Mm-hmm.
So backend here we have the data.
Mm-hmm.
Means use when the user is requested to the backend. It will have the some business logic will be there. Otherwise, the data will from the database. It need to pull the data and again it will send back to the front end. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Up to here, you are clear, right?
Mm-hmm.
So depend upon the user requirements, the backend will be take care of remaining things like how to process the data and what are the data we need to send. If the user requested the contact us page, okay, the backend will take care of the things and it will send the what are the things need to display in the contact us page. Same data it will send to the front end. Okay, the front end we have the some of the things will be there. It cannot understand the back end data. Okay, it will have the only some of the things only it will be understand. First it will give the high priority for the HTML. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Next it will understand the CSS. Okay. Next TypeScript.
Okay.
And Angular. So we got the data in a different formats from the backend. So only the data which will browser will be understand is only HTML, CSS, TypeScript, and Angular. Okay. If the backend data sends the Java also, it will unable to understand. Okay. So backend need to take care that the process need to be done from the backend and it need to send data back to the in format of HTML, CSS, TypeScript, and Angular formats only. Okay.
Yeah.
Here we'll call them as an HTML. HTML will normally we'll say them as is a presentation logic map. Here we will mention. Presentation logic means which is related like show and hiding the buttons and like what are the things like depend upon the user roles and responsibility. We want to show the content or we want to hide the content. Those all the things we can do from the front end. Okay, but we cannot compile the script. We cannot run the servers from the inside of the browser. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So when we are interacting with the backend, we will use the most of the things like APIs. Okay. So with the help of the APIs, we'll get the data. Okay, how we are interacting with the backend means with the help of an APIs, we are interacting with the backend. Okay, man? So here I will write. So application programming interface. So it will most of the things, it will fetch the data from the different servers as well, not our own servers. If you want to book the railway ticket, we are doing from the one application, but the railway database in the inside of a government. Okay. So it will fetch the data and it will show it to us. Okay. Suppose if you want to book the flight ticket, we want to compare the different service providers like SpiceJet, Indigo, American, okay, or the Europe thing, any service providers. So we can easily fetch the data and we can compare this one. How it is possible is with the help of an APIs only it is able to possible. Okay, so they are interacting with the different servers and fetch the data and they are going to show in a single format. Okay. This is come. So we are opening any one application. Okay. So inside of application, we are accessing the different APIs. Okay.
Yeah.
So, ma'am, you are from India, right?
Yeah, I'm from India. Hello.
Yeah, ma'am. India location.
Yeah. I'm actually from Hyderabad. Varangal. Like my mother tongue is not Telugu, but Nakustadi.
HTTP services with the help of the HTTP service formats, we will fetch the data. Okay. So, India, Book My Show idea, Book My Show, Gani, Amazon sites, Gani, even allow work out the end. With the help of the APIs only, we can fetch the data and we can show in the front end.
Yeah.
Suppose if I go and show you some of the things like in a live data, right. So I am going to the Make My Trip site application. Okay. This is a one of the service provider who can help us to book the flight ticket. Okay. But yeah. I am going to book the flight ticket from the SpiceJet or if anything is related. Okay. When I'm clicking on the search button. Okay. See here. First one is Air India. Okay. And we have the different okay. See, ma'am, is the left side. Just I'm showing you Air India, Air Asia, Go Air, Indigo, SpiceJet. Okay, these are the different airlines. Okay, what he is right with the help of an APIs, he interacted with the servers of this particular companies. Okay, then only he can fetch the data and he can show in a third party application. Okay,
yeah,
okay. This is the most advantage recently they have added in the what is it from the front end or back end, we can say. Okay, because of these things only we are doing the most of the online transactions. Okay, if you go and book the movie tickets or if you go and interact with the like an Uber tickets or anything else, suppose you want to travel from one location to other location also, we are going to use these things. Okay, with the help of the APIs and HTTP request only, it is able to possible. Okay, if we don't have these things, we if you want to book the Air Asia flight ticket, you need to go to the Air Asia web application only. Okay, if you want to book the flight ticket from the SpiceJet, you need to go and access to their particular application only. Okay,
yeah,
you got my point, right?
Yes.
The help of these things only happen. Okay, so majorly my India Samante APIs and the manaku back end team wall is the okay,
yeah,
back end team wall is there. Then it chase manamu our data is this coach quantum. Okay, data means we'll call them as it will in a JSON format and matter. Okay, data which is a put good manaku JSON format. Okay, a JSON format on the data and one of raw data and then the India Samante front end beautify the chase cone. Manaku put you be some raw data lime on to the ante. Suppose UK 815, 820, New Delhi, Iran, New Dermat, then you put Manaku front end Kalai the Kawana, then structure of Petkurman display chess. Okay, Alani Air India or flight number or something data pump is not okay. What is someone's data? The Ilajupi somewhat okay. Suppose you can start date, ni, you start on a variable of Pompisanad. Okay, we start. Okay, Air India will start at time and Pompichad. Okay, our Rundu clone a variable name, slow and JSON format of data. Ni, man compare this one back end law and a back end means you can a business mean front end of component. Lo, okay, compare this one what Nick Sargat, I mean what you tagged Raskuntamano. Okay, Raskun front end law start date and okay, worse go check. Start date and sorry, start time. Okay,
yeah.
Okay. Okay. It is work like a mediator. Mediator means if you are working with a ship port and kuna. Okay. One second. Okay, this report lo manako server lo data untundandi. Okay, okay, server means it is we'll call them as a ship. Okay, okay, this ship lo data anedi okay. ఈ పోర్ HTTP అనేది ఇమిడియట్ లా వర్క్ అవుతుంది ఇక్కడ మనకు. ఓకే, అంటే టూ టైమ్స్ లో ఇట్ విల్ ఫెచ్ ద డేటా అండ్ ఇట్ విల్ ओके मन एपड़ता एपीएन हिट चेयर विद द हेल्प ऑफ द एचटीटीपी ओनली वी कैन हिट द डेटा एंड शी विल प्रोसेस द डेटा एंड ए डेटा अयिते मन कावनो प्रोसेस चेसि इट विल सेंड बैक टू विद द हेल्प ऑफ द एचटीटीपी ओनली टू द पोर्ट अन्नमाट ओके పోర్ట్ అంటే మన ఫ్రంట్ ఎండ్ అప్లికేషన్ అన్నమాట ఇక్కడికి పంపిస్తుంది ఓకే యా దిస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ అదర్ వి కెన్ కాల్ దెం విత్ ది హెల్ప్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ HTTP సర్వీసెస్ ఓన్లీ ఇట్ విల్ కాల్ అదర్వైస్ విల్ కాల్ దెం ఎండ్ పాయింట్స్ అన్నమాట ఓకే APIs ని ఎండ్ పాయింట్స్ అని కూడా అంటాం ఓకే HTTP అనేది సర్వీస్ అన్నమాట అది ఓకే ఇక్కడ డిఫరెంట్ డిఫరెంట్ మెథడ్స్ ఉంటాయి లైక్ గెట్ సారీ గెట్ పోస్ట్ డిలీట్ ఆ ప్రాసెస్ అవన్నీ మెథడ్స్ అన్నమాట ఓకే షిప్ లో డేటా అనేది ఇక్కడ ప్రాసెస్ అనేది షిప్ క్యాప్టెన్ చూసుకుంటాడు అనుకుందాం ఓకే అంటే క్యాప్టెన్ కి ఏదైనా ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ వస్తే ఏ డేటా పంపించాలనేది టేక్ కేర్ బై ద షిప్ అనమాట ఓకే HTTP ఇట్ విల్ డోంట్ హ్యావ్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఎల్స్ ఇన్ దట్ వన్ జస్ట్ మన డేటా పంపించడము మళ్ళీ తీసుకొచ్చి బ్యాక్ డేటా ఎలా ఉందో అలానే పంపిస్తుంది అది ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ డూ ఎనీ ప్రాసెస్ ఆర్ ఇట్ విల్ నాట్ డూ ఎనీ మోడిఫికేషన్ ఇన్ ద డేటా ఓకే ఇస్ ఇట్ ఫైన్ అండి Till now, we have learned the what can say the basic things about the Angular and okay introduction versions and why we are using the Angular everything okay. So right now I am going to install Angular in our application sorry in our system and okay.
Okay.
From the, yeah for that. So Angular you can use sorry for the installation of Angular we require some of the things and okay. The things I am going to show you. First is a node only. Okay.
Yeah.
So we can go to the node.org application org.com. Oh, sorry, org. Here, depend upon the system, we can install the what is the latest version you want to install. Okay. Suppose if you want to install the recommended version means LTS in a standard mem. Okay. It's a long term. Which given support from the long term means you can use for the learning purpose as well as for the development purpose also we can use okay why because it's developed in the long time okay so it is a latest version which we can do but when you are developing any application in a real time scenario don't take the current version ma'am okay we don't know what are the drawbacks from this and we don't know where exactly it is going to fail okay for testing purpose and you want to more explore on the new features at the time you are going to use this one ma'am okay most suggestible way endante LTS anedi mee system lo install cheskondi suppose meer mac aithe meer automatic ga mac ni install cheyandi windows aithe windows install cheyandi
yeah
like also meeku edaina specific versions gaani specific kavali ante meer ikkadiki velthe meeku different different versions current version no manaku versions kuda selections untayi ma'am aa versions kuda select cheskochu okay
yeah
మీకు నోడ్ ఇన్స్టాలేషన్ ఐడియా ఉందా మేడం అంటే మీ మెషిన్ లో ఉందా
ఉంది ఆల్రెడీ
అంటే మీకు NPM కూడా ఐడియా ఉందా మీకు VS కోడ్ గాని
యా అంటే నేను ప్రాజెక్ట్ కోసమా నేను యూస్ చేసుకున్నాను
ఓకే ఆ మీకు ఇన్స్టాలేషన్స్ అవన్నీ క్లారిటీ ఉంది కదా
విజువల్ స్టూడియో కోడ్ విజువల్ స్టూడియో కోడ్ ఉంది
లేదంటే విజువల్ కోడ్ డాట్ విజువల్ స్టూడియో కోడ్ కి వెళ్ళి ఇక్కడ ఇన్స్టాల్ చేసుకోండి ఓకే ఎందుకంటే నా మెషిన్ లో ఆల్రెడీ ఉన్నాయి నేను డైరెక్ట్ వెళ్ళిపోతున్నాను అన్నమాట అందుకోసం మీకు ఒకసారి చెప్తున్నా అంటే మీ దగ్గర లేకపోతే పర్సనల్ డివైస్
యా నోడ్ అండ్ విజువల్ స్టూడియో
ఉన్న తర్వాత నెక్స్ట్ వెళ్ళేసేయండి నేను ఏం చేస్తున్నా అంటే ఇక్కడ ప్యాకేజ్ డైరెక్ట్ ఫోల్డర్ కి వచ్చేసి కమాండ్ ప్రామిట్ టైప్ చేస్తున్నాను అండి కమాండ్ ప్రామిట్ వీ కెన్ టైప్ విత్నే డైరెక్ట్లీ మనం ఇక్కడ సిఎండి అని టైప్ చేస్తే ఇట్ విల్ ఓపెన్ ద కమాండ్ ప్రామిట్ కమాండ్ విండో అండి ఓకే అదర్వైజ్ విత్ ద హెల్ప్ ఆఫ్ ద నార్మల్ ఓకే ఇక్కడ నేను యాంగులర్ ఇన్స్టాల్ కోసం ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు యూస్ NPM ఓకే ఇన్స్టాల్ ఓకే -G ఓకే గ్లోబల్ కి ఇన్స్టాల్ చేస్తున్నా ఏం యాంగులర్ కి ఎట్ ద రేట్ సింబల్ యాంగులర్ ఐఎమ్ టైపింగ్ ఓకే ఓకే ఇట్స్ గోయింగ్ టు డూ ద ఇన్స్టాలేషన్స్ అండి ఓకే
సో ఆల్రెడీ యాంగులర్ ఉందా లేదా ఎలా చెక్ చేసుకోవాలి
వర్షన్ చెక్ చేసుకుంటూ వస్తుందండి ఒక ఇప్పుడు ఇది మధ్యలో ఆగిపోతుంది నేను తర్వాత చూపిస్తాను ఓకే
ఓకే
ఫోల్డర్ స్ట్రక్చర్ కానీ ప్రాజెక్ట్ స్ట్రక్చర్ అవన్నీ రేపు ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేస్తాం మీకు అండి ఓకే ఎందుకంటే ఇది కొంచెం టైం తీసుకుంటుంది ఇన్స్టాల్ అవుతుంది
ఓకే అంటే ప్రాజెక్ట్ చేసేటప్పుడు మేము యూస్ చేసాము సో అది తీసేసానో లేదో నాకు గుర్తులేదు అందుకే యాంగులర్ వర్షన్ చూస్తే
ఇప్పుడు అయిపోయిన తర్వాత నేను ఏం చేస్తాను అంటే ఇక్కడ ఎంజి వర్షన్ కొడతాను మేడం. ఓకే ఇక్కడ చూడండి 10.2.0 వచ్చింది. ఓకే నోడ్ వర్షన్ వచ్చింది, నా ఆపరేటింగ్ సిస్టమ్ కూడా మొత్తం వచ్చిందండి ఇక్కడ. ఓకే
నాకు ఒక్కసారి కమాండ్ చెప్పరా?
వర్షన్
ఇన్స్టాల్ ఎన్పిఎం ఇన్స్టాల్ ది
ఎన్పిఎం ఇన్స్టాల్
ఇన్స్టాల్
ఐఫోన్ జి
NPM is not recognized అని వస్తుంది.
నోడ్ ప్యాకేజ్ మేనేజర్ ఇన్స్టాల్ చేశారండి? కాదండి, మీరు విండోస్ మ్యాక్ ఆ విషయం చెప్పండి.
విండోస్ అది
NPM ప్యాకేజ్ మేనేజర్ ఇన్స్టాల్ చేశారండి?
NPM.js
ఓకే ఈ నోడ్ ప్యాకేజ్ మేనేజర్ చూసారా మీరు NPM?
యా ఇది చేయండి.
దీన్ని ఇన్స్టాల్ చేశారా? దీన్ని కూడా ఇన్స్టాల్ చేయాల్సి ఉంటుందండి.
ఓకే
దీన్ని ఇన్స్టాల్ చేసిన తర్వాత యూ కెన్ వర్క్ విత్ దట్ అండి. నేను ఒకసారి కమాండ్ రన్ చేయాలండి, ఒక సెకండ్ మీకు ఇక్కడ చూస్తే టైం పడుతుంది. యాంగులర్ ప్రాజెక్ట్ ఇన్స్టాల్ చేయడానికి ఎన్జి న్యూ, మన న్యూ ప్రాజెక్ట్ కాబట్టి న్యూ అని ఎంటర్ చేసి ప్రాజెక్ట్ నేమ్ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు ఎంటర్. ఓకే మనం ఏం చేస్తున్నాం, యాంగులర్ 16 అని ఎంటర్ చేస్తున్నాండి. ఓకే ఇదేనా నా ఫోల్డర్ నేమ్, ఈ పేరుతో మన ఫోల్డర్ ప్రాజెక్ట్ క్రియేట్ అవుతుంది. ఓకే దెన్ ఐఎమ్ క్లికింగ్ అని ఎంటర్. ఓకే చూడండి, ఇక్కడ ఎంటర్ చేసిన తర్వాత ఇట్ విల్ ఆస్క్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద క్వశ్చన్స్ టు యూ, ఇన్ యువర్ అప్లికేషన్ వి రిక్వైర్ రౌటింగ్. ఓకే మనకి ఎస్ అయితే వై ఆర్ నో కొట్టచ్చు. ఓకే నేను అన్నిటికి వై కొడతాను. ఓకే ఓకే వి కెన్ యూస్ ద సిఎస్ఎస్ టాస్ ఇవన్నీ ఆప్షన్స్ అడుగుతుంది. ఓకే నార్మల్లీ వీఆర్ లెర్నింగ్ రైట్, ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు యూస్ సిఎస్ఎస్ అనమాట. ఓకే అండ్ దెన్ సమ్టైమ్స్ ఇట్ విల్ ఆల్సో టైప్ స్క్రిప్ట్ ఆల్సో. ఓకే టైప్ స్క్రిప్ట్ అడిగితే కూడా ఎస్ అని కొడతాను. ఓకే ఎందుకంటే నేను టైప్ స్క్రిప్ట్ కూడా మీకు చూపిస్తాను. ఓకే సో ఇట్ విల్ టేక్ సమ్ టైమ్ అండి. ఓకే యూ కెన్ డూ ఇట్. అరే ఆ క్వశ్చన్స్ అవి చెప్తాను మీకు. హలో మ్యామ్.
yes
మీకు అవుతుందండి, ఏమైనా డౌట్ ఉందా?
అది చూస్తున్నాను ఒకసారి, అంటే నోట్ డాట్ జేఎస్ ఇన్స్టాల్ చేస్తున్నామండి.
మీరు ఇన్స్టాల్ చేయండి, నేను బీన్ టైంలో మీకు ఇది కూడా పంపిస్తాను. ఓకే, ఇది ఎట్లా నాకు టైం తీసుకుంటుంది, 15-20 మినిట్స్. రేపు మార్నింగ్ మీకు ఏం చేస్తా అంటే ఈ ఫోల్డర్ స్ట్రక్చర్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేస్తాను, స్ట్రక్చర్ ఆఫ్ ద యాంగులర్ ప్రాజెక్ట్ అవన్నీ ఇన్స్టాల్ చేస్తాను. అప్పటి లోపల నాకు ఏమవుతాయి అంటే ఇవి ఇన్స్టాల్ అయిపోతాయి అండి ఇక్కడ. ఓకే,
ఫోల్డర్
వస్తుంది, దీని లోపల నోడ్ మాడ్యూల్స్ ఇవన్నీ వస్తాయి. సేమ్ మీరు కూడా ట్రై చేయండి, నేను ఆల్రెడీ కమెంట్స్ ఈ ఫైల్ అన్ని పెడుతున్నాను మీకు, జస్ట్ రిఫరెన్స్ లాగా ఈ ఫైల్ ఐడియా వచ్చేస్తుంది. ఓకే, టుమారో సేమ్ టైం అండి, మీకు ఏమైనా పాసిబిలిటీ ఉందో అవుతుందా అండి, అంటే 7 o'clock అయ్యేసి అంటే 1.5 hour బిఫోర్
అంటే 7:30 ఇన్ ద మార్నింగ్ ఆ మీకు
7 o'clock అండి.
అర్థం కాలేదండి.
7 o'clock అండి.
7 కి పొద్దున 7 కా
సేమ్ టైం కి ఒక 1.5 hour బిఫోర్ అండి. బికాజ్ మీరు
యా అండి, యా లైక్ ఐ బి మోస్ట్లీ ఫ్రీ, అంటే నాకు ట్యూస్డే ఇంకా థర్స్డేస్ క్లాసెస్ ఉంటాయండి, సో ఆ 2 డేస్ అడ్జస్ట్ చేసుకుందాము అంటే నాకు మిగతా డేస్ ఓకే. 7 కి
థ్యాంక్స్ అండి, బాయ్. ఈ ఫైల్ మీకు పంపిస్తాను నేను. ఓకే,
యా ప్లీజ్, ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ.
హలో
హలో
నవిత ఆర్ వెంకట్ ఎవరున్నారండి? క్రిష్ప్ నుంచి ఎవరున్నారండి? హలో
మీరు రికార్డ్ ఒకవేళ చేస్తే నాకు రికార్డ్ అయింది కూడా పంపిస్తారా?
వచ్చింది, అది అది వస్తుంది అండి, ఎలాగైనా వస్తుంది అది. ఓకే, కొంచెం ప్రాసెస్ అవుతుంది అది, ఒక 15-20 హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్ పట్టింది, హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్ తర్వాత వాళ్ళు పంపిస్తారండి మీకు.
సార్
ఫైల్స్ నేను పంపిస్తాను, అంటే నేను వీళ్ళకి పంపిస్తే వీళ్ళు మిమ్మల్ని మీకు షేర్ చేస్తారండి. ఓకే
ఓకే అండి, నో వరీస్.
అందుకే షార్ట్ కట్స్ అన్ని రాస్తున్నాను కదా, షార్ట్ కట్స్ అన్ని మీకు పంపిస్తారు.
ఓకే,
వీళ్ళు మీకు షేర్ చేస్తే జస్ట్ మీకు ఒక ఐడియా వస్తుంది ఇది ఏంది అనేది, అందుకోసం లైట్ గా ఎడ్డింగ్స్
పెడుతుంటారు. దెన్ ఐ లీవ్ అండి మరి.
ఆ ష్యూర్ అండి, థాంక్స్ అండి.
మీరు లీవ్ అవ్వండి, కనెక్ట్ అవుతాం.
సరే అండి, 7 o'clock. ఓకే,
యా, థాంక్ యూ.
Yeah.